what would happen in the old age? Now we can say, you know, कि हम लोग इतने काबिल होंगे कि या वृद्ध आश्रम वाले देख लेंगे, बट प्रैक्टिकली मैं अपने लाइफ में अगर देखता हूँ कि अगर मेरी मदर थी वो अभी बीमार हुई थी, एंड हम लोग ने अगर मतलब कि अगर हम लोग नहीं होते देन उनको प्रॉब्लम होती.
आर यू लाइक योर मदर?
नो.
देन व्हाई आर यू कंपेयरिंग?
और मेरे फादर भी थे वो भी.
योर मदर पेड फॉर अ डिपेंडेंट लाइफ. Do you first of all want to be dependent? Then why are you weaving stories?
But my father, he was...
He too would have been dependent. Why do you want to be dependent in the first place?
He wasn't. He's not dependent. He's...
Then why does he need you? He needs doctors and nurses.
Yes, but...
Are you a doctor?
No.
Then what would you do?
But he does not... Yeah, but then... Because he spent all the money on us, now he does not have that.
Don't do that. Don't spend all the money on 5 kids. Keep something for yourself and your old age. In old age, you need medicine, not sons. And if you want a caretaker, hire a nurse.
That's right, because we all are living outside. They both are living alone and they are living good life.
How many sons anyway return from abroad to take care of their parents? Sitting in some native village in Uttar Pradesh, does that happen? And why do you need to drag your life till 95 years of age? If you find that you have turned debilitated at 80, switch it off. Do you really need to continue living for 120 years? Live a rich, fulfilled life, and when you find that you are on the verge of becoming dependent, then call it off. Not one hair in your head is grey and you are worrying about old age. Why must you turn so pathetically old in the first place? I am asking you. If you are healthy, then continue to live on 90, 95. It's okay, because you are still healthy and strong and on your own. But the day you find you are tied to the bed and dependent on others for every small thing, why do you still want to keep breathing? Call it a day. Done. Lived enough, lived richly. I can retire now, can't I?
Is it not a sensible decision, like looking at the condition of the country, the temperature is rising, to move to a better country where population is less and...
Climate change doesn't differentiate between countries. Wherever you go, the battle has to be fought. You can fight it here, you can fight it there. If you think you can fight it better over there, then do shift. As far as I am concerned, I would want to be in the thick of the battle. I would want to fight where the problem really is. Why escape away to some land where people are already more aware, more responsible? The bulk of population growth in the coming few decades is going to come from countries like India. What would I do by preaching these things to the Japanese? Their population is already reducing. They will become extinct if I preach a little more to them. These things need to be drilled into Indians, because this is the place from where most of the world's population growth is going to come. Sorry, sir, look at the growth rates. What are you talking of? India is the third biggest emitter of carbon. You are probably talking of per capita emissions. Why talk of per capita thing? After China and the US, India stands at number three. And in terms of yearly growth, India is number one. We all want progress, you know. And every bit of that which you call as progress is carbon emitting. Every bit of that which you call as the good life is carbon emitting. A fellow comes from a small town to live in Bangalore. His carbon footprint probably increases 5 times. But you call it progress. You call it urbanization. A fellow moves from a small house to a big house. His carbon footprint increases 4 times. But you say it's great. A fellow gets a higher paying job and gets 2 more air conditioners. He has done his share of damage to the earth. But he'll say, you know, this is progress. Progress itself is the problem. As long as there are so many people progressing. If you want to progress, then let there be a quarter of people that there are. Then you can have all these progresses. But you cannot have the kind of per capita consumption of resources that probably the US currently has, with the kind of population that India currently has. But that is what we want. We want the population of India to be multiplied by the per capita consumption of the US. And that is catastrophic. If you want per capita consumption levels of the developed countries, then you reduce your population to the level of developed countries. You cannot have the population of India, but the per capita consumption of Germany. Unfortunately, that is what we want.